Hi everyone, my name is Tomer Ezra, and I'm going to talk about fair share allocations for agents with arbitrary entitlements. This is based on joint work with Moshe Babaioff and Uriel Feige. In this talk, we are going to consider the problem of fair division of indivisible goods among agents with arbitrary entitlements. In our setting, we have N agents, each with an entitlement BJ, a set of items M of M items. We want to allocate the items to the agents where an allocation is a partition of the items into N disjoint bundles. We assume setting without monetary transfers. To illustrate the setting, consider, for example, the scenario of partitioning labs between two departments. We have the math department and the computer science department. And the computer science department is bigger and is entitled for 60% of the labs, while the math department is only entitled for 40% of the labs. We have three labs that we need to allocate, of sizes 5, 9, and 3. In this example, the value of each lab is its size for both departments, but in general, the agents might have different values for each lab. An example of an allocation is to give the first lab of value 5 to the math department, while giving both other labs to the computer science department. To decide whether an allocation is fair, we use the share-based approach. In the share-based approach, we define a reasonable share function that maps a valuation and an entitlement to a value that represents what the agent is expecting to receive. In this approach, the value does not depend on what other agent receive, such as in the NV3 fairness approach. A simple example for a share function is the proportional share, that is, the value of all items multiplied by the entitlement. The main problem of the proportional share, for the case of indivisible goods, is that we cannot give all agents their proportional share, and even more than this, we cannot give any constant approximation to the proportional share. Another well-studied share, for the case of equal entitlements, is the max-min share. The max-min share of an agent, or in short, the MMS, is the maximal value one can guarantee to the least happy agent if all agents have the same valuation, VJ. That is, the maximum over all partitions into N bundles of the value of the least valued bundle in the partition. And this is why it is called the max-min. An example is if there are four agents with five items and additive values of 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, then the best partition that maximizes the value of the least valued bundle is when putting the 2 and 3 together, which shows that the max-min is at least 4. Since this is the best partition, then the max-min is exactly 4. There are few attempts in generalizing the max-min share into the case of unequal entitlements. One attempt is the definition of the weighted max-min share, or in short, the WMMS. I won't get into the definition of the WMMS, but one issue with the MMS is that if you have an agent with an entitlement of 0.99, and there are 100 identical items of value 1, then the WMMS might still be 0 in some cases, depending on the entitlements of other agents. Although it makes sense that the agent should get at least some items. Another extension is that of the pessimistic share. The pessimistic share is the maximum over all P over Q, that are at most BJ, of the maximum partition into Q bundles when receiving the least favorable P bundles. Babaioff et al. Defined this share, but they did not provide any existence result of any approximation to the share. Let's continue to our suggestion, which is the any price share, or APS in short. In the any price share, we view the entitlements as a budget, and the any price share is just the value that you can always buy for any normalized vector of prices. So this is the minimum over all prices of the maximum value that can be purchased using a budget of BJ. The value depends only on the valuation and the entitlement, and therefore satisfies our definition of a share. In the paper, we give a dual definition that is more similar to the maximin share. The dual definition of the any price share is the largest value SJ, such that there is a weighted collection of bundles, such that all bundles have a value of at least SJ, the sum of weights is 1, and each item appears in bundles of at most weight BJ. This definition is a fractional definition of the maximin share. And this definition and the definition that uses the prices are primal dual linear programs, hence their values are the same. The maximin share is the integral definition of the second one, where the weights of all bundles needs to be exactly 1 over n. Back to the example in the first slide, then the any price share of the math department is 3. This can be seen since for every pricing, the math department can afford at least 1 item. And this is why the value is at least 3. And the value is at most 3 because of the falling pricing, where the department cannot afford more than the least valued level. The any price share of the computer science department is 8. This is since they can always either purchase the big lab or the 2 smaller labs, and the following pricing shows that they cannot guarantee more than 8. Another example with an entitlement of 0.4, and for items with values 2, 1, 1, 1, and in this case, the any price share is 2. This is since for every pricing, an agent can either afford the big item B or can afford 2 of the small items. Another way to see it, using the dual definition, is by constructing the weighted collection with 1 bundle containing only the big item B with a weight of 2 over 5 and 3 bundles containing 2 small items each with weight of 1 over 5. Each bundle has a value of 2 and each item has a weight of at most 2 over 5. In contrast, the pessimistic share in this example is 1. This is since if we divide into 5 bundles, then the best partition gives a value of 1. Also, it holds for the case of dividing into 3 bundles and cannot help to partition into more bundles than 5. We show in the paper that the pessimistic share is at most the any price share and is at least half of it. On the other hand, the WMMS can vary between 0 and 2. Depending on how the remaining of the 0.6 entitlement is split among other agents. In the special case of an entitlement of 1 over k, for an integer k, then the any price share is at least the maximin share, with respect to k agents. And in some cases, the inequality is strict, as in the following example. We have 15 items with the following values. The maximin share is 96, and this is by case analysis. On the other hand, the any price share is 97. To see this, it is easier to put the items in a table and then duplicate the items by mirroring over the diagonal. Every row has a value of 97. So if we give each row with weight of 1 over 6, we get a weighted collection that satisfies the dual definition. This is a valid weighted collection since an item does not appear twice in the same row. Our main result is by providing an algorithm that returns an allocation that gives every agent at least 3/5 of her any price share for arbitrary entitlements and additive valuations. Can be computed efficiently even without knowing the value of the any price share. This is the first constant approximation for a share in an unequal entitlement settings. In addition, we show how to give a two-thirds approximation to the APS in the special case of equal entitlements. Moreover, we show that the allocation that maximizes the Nash social welfare does not give any approximation to the any price share, which was not true for the equal entitlement case. We prove our main result using the following bidding game. Every agent starts with their entitlement as a budget, and in every round, all agents place a bid of at most their current budget. The highest bid wins, and she can purchase any number of items she wants, paying her bid for each. This allocation mechanism is not truthful, but has procedural fairness in the sense that a priori it does not favor any agent. We show that in this game there are safe strategies that guarantees a good approximation to the any price share. In the paper, we present safe strategy that give each agent at least 3/5 of her any price share. This implies our main result, since if all agents play their safe strategy, the result allocation gives every agent at least 3/5 of her APS. Since the safe strategy guaranteeing 3/5 of her APS is a bit complicated, in the remainder of this talk, we will present a simpler safe strategy that guarantees an agent with strictly more than half of her any price share. The first step of the safe strategy is to normalize the values such that the APS of the agent equals to her entitlement. This is possible since in our definition of the APS, if we multiply all values by constant, then the APS is also multiplied by the same constant. Then, in every round, the agent bids her value for the most valuable available item, and if she does not have enough budget, then she bids all her budget. If she wins, she purchases only the most valuable item. This strategy guarantees strictly more than half of her any price share. The bidding game then can be described as three stages. In the first stage, which might be empty, she cannot afford to buy any item. In the second stage, she has enough budget to give her bid, and then again in stage 3, she cannot afford to bid her most valuable item. If she wins an item in the first stage, then she gets at least her APS. Else, someone else purchased items, and we show that in this case, her any price share with the proportional remaining budget restricted to the remaining items does not decrease. In the rest of the proof, since she always purchases the item she wants the most, then when the second stage ends, then she used strictly more than half of her budget. And the percent of the budget that she spent in this stage is the percent of the APS she receives, which concludes the proof. An immediate corollary is that if all agents use this strategy, then we get an allocation that gives every agent strictly more than half of her any price share. Let's see an example of this strategy. Recall the earlier example where the agent has an entitlement of 2/5 and there are 4 items with values 2, 1, 1, and 1. The any price share of the agent is 2, thus after scaling the values, the scale values are 2/5, 1/5, 1/5, and 1/5. In the first round, the agent bids 2/5. If she wins, the game ends and she gets a value of 2. Else, she bids 1/5 for the next 3 rounds as long as her budget allows it. And since other agents has a remaining budget of 1/5, then she will win in at least 2 rounds, gaining a value of 2. To summarize, we introduced the any price share is a natural share function that maps an entitlement and valuation to a value. We presented 2 equivalent definitions, one that uses prices, and the second which is a fractional definition of the max-min share. For equal entitlements, the any price share is at least the max-min share, and in some cases, it is strictly more. Since we cannot give each agent her maximum share, even for the equal entitlement case, we aim for a constant approximation. We presented an algorithm giving 3/5 approximation to the any price share. There are many open questions besides studying the any price share in settings beyond the additive valuations. For additive valuations, there are still some gaps to be closed. For equal entitlements, it remains to understand what is the gap between the any price share and the maximum share, and what approximation can be achieved to the any price share. And also for the case of unequal entitlements, what is the best approximation to the any price share can be achieved. Thank you a lot for your attention.